Some of the critics may not like the film, but when you're a Beatle fan, what do their views matter? Just the thought of being within a few feet of Paul McCartney, now a very well-preserved 42-year-old, had them in tears in Manhattan. Earlier, when he and his wife Linda arrived at a launching party, every other person seemed to be a bodyguard or a public relations officer. A promised 5-minute interview turned into a scramble for a few precious words.
BBC? All right!
Yeah,
definitely.
For the BBC?
Fine.
I think we're lost.
So
okay, Bob.
Okay. What was this about, the new film? Can you tell me, first of all, because we haven't seen it generally in the UK, what it's all about?
Yeah, it's about some tapes of an album that go missing. And the fellow who's suspected of taking him is a sort of friend of mine, and I stick up for him. There's a lot of songs, and hopefully it's a good evening out.
What sort of impression have you got so far from the people who've had a preview of the film?
The people seem to like it. I'm not going to say too much, you know, I don't want to count my chickens, but it looks like a good reaction so far.
So some people who have seen it in London have said that maybe the plot is a little slight.
Yeah, well, you know, it wasn't kind of conceived as a deep drama. I mean, if you look at things like Indiana Jones, the plot's slight, you know, it's actually second time you see it, it's less slight.
One thing that intrigues me, as I'm sure it intrigues other people, is you've done so well over the years. You're very famous, obviously, you can tell by the crush here. Why did you decide to make a film?
I just fancy doing it, really. You know, I made music for so long, I mean, I fancy a little bit of a change. It seemed like a fresh challenge, Bob. So I just got on with it and made it.
There are reports here of long queues for Give My Regards to Broad Street. Admittedly, the critics don't seem over-impressed. The plot, says one, is so inconsequential that most of the time is taken up by 14 musical numbers, most of which are McCartney oldies, staged in sometimes elaborate but mostly unenticing ways. But the film also includes McCartney's No More Lonely Nights, which is already number 2 in the British hit parade.
Yes, I know what I feel to be right. No more lonely nights, never be another. No more lonely nights.
It was certainly no lonely night for Paul McCartney. For hours, stars and other beautiful people arrived for the party. But many of them got nowhere near their host because of the crush. Tonight you're surrounded by people. It amazes me how you put up with it over the years. Does it ever get to you at all?
We don't do it that often. And, you know, the people are positive, and it's quite fun when people are happy.
Well, right? Well, not too bad.
Okay, that's fine.
We got to go, though.
Thanks so much. Nice to see you.